Okay. Well, I want to show you my progress learning Unity 3D. Let's do some notable mentions. The game which you will see, I created during workshop. It's a workshop. It's like video tutorials from Mike Geig, and yeah, I was kind of successful with that because the project itself was made for the Unity 4, but I have refactored it to the Unity 5. It was not so much big amount of work actually, done with one day of work, but still it's kind of interesting. So what you actually see here, I have texture. I have to taken assets which were provided to me, and then I just done some paintbrush, kind of simplified paintbrush, and you can see clearly the skies which are provided by one of the assets which I have downloaded freely from asset store. Then you have here game objects like this robot, which generated continuously by the script, game script, which responsible for the robot, and I kind of gathering the score. And you see that I have, like, when I hit three objects, collected three objects, the score is displayed at the game over screen, and my mouse icon is displayed. So basically, what I have learned, I have learned that Unity 4 is kind of working. I mean, the code from Unity 4 you can use it in Unity 5, and most things which I have missed is like having generating own assets. Maybe this is next step in my continuous learning of Unity 3D, will be like understand how to generate own assets, because I mean, if you get assets from the store, they're not always the best quality, even if you pay something for the assets. But for me, it's kind of next huge step in learning Unity. So basically, I have created kind of pretty simplified game and 3D game, and sure, it's interesting to notice that it's very important to understand how Unity call main functions like update, start, awake, and furthermore. But other things which I always struggle, it's like how I can reference objects by not using public access modifier. So I have C# classes where I declare fields, and I do not use public in my project, and means that I can only use things like find by tag or find object. I mean game object find, and then I specify what I need to search. And I use, of course, prefabs. So you see the spots. The spots are generated game object, and I have a script to which I assign the spawn points, and then they are loaded, and I have here collision. So when my player hits the object, it counted, and my timer is updated when I have successful hit, and if I do not successfully able to hit something, one of the spawn points, through the amount of time which I have, like, I have 11-10 seconds to hit the target, then it's updated. Should be updated. Let me... Yeah. I have kind of... the code is not mine, it's a refactored code from the project, same type of project from the Mike Geig. I think he works at Unity nowadays, but for me it's kind of interesting and the performance quite high. I'm using a GeForce card. Let me quickly show you which type of the card I'm using in the project. And let me just quickly do that. Yeah, GeForce GT 1030. And yeah, that's it from my side. Quite kind of right. I have done not so much games, but I mean the stuff which I do in learning Unity, build prototypes, evaluate the best possible design patterns and just gather some experience on building prototypes, because I mean when you go to the big project there are tons of code. And one topic still have my concern, it's unit testing in Unity3D. I hope to get some professional help from Unity and pay some money for that, actually, to be even better in programming the games with the help of Unity3D. But as you see, it is possible with minimal resources to build such simplified prototype. All assets are free and you just need to spend some time to get the stuff configured and then program the stuff. But I did not found any big points where I was stuck. I mean, what I see in learning Unity, as soon as you figure it out as a way how to approach your games in the best possible programming way, then it's never big challenge to do even more difficult stuff. But last notable mentions, thank you Mike Geig for the provided information, and I hope to advance even more. So basically I'm still in paper prototyping of my own game, turn-based game, strategy game, and that's what I need to say today. So thank you for watching, sorry for bubbling through it, but I hope you get some sort of impression how far I got into the Unity, and for me it's very good sign that kind of progress happens on my side. So thank you all and bye bye. Thank you.